from Satyasai High School. I hope you are enjoying at home and you watched your previous videos. After a short break, now we are ready with the new session with new videos. And today's topic is communication. Communication, effective communication. Communication means, first, what is communication? Communication means transferring of information or ideas or thoughts from one person to another person. Transferring of ideas, thoughts and information from one person to another person is called communication. If you are having a information or if you want to express your thoughts and ideas to somebody else, how can you express or how can you tell? You have to take the help of a language. Language is a medium which helps us to communicate effectively to the other person. Now we are learning how to communicate in English with the others. In any language, to communicate effectively, there is no need of grammar. Just we have to know the some basic knowledge of the language, and we have to know the meaning of every word and sentence which we are using in our communication. Then we can able to communicate effectively with the other person. For example, we are speaking in Telugu regularly and effectively and fluently because it is our mother language, mother tongue. We are not having an idea of grammar about Telugu. And sometimes if we are residing outside for 6 months or 1 year, we are automatically we are learning that local language. How we can able to learn? First we will learn some small words and meaning of that words, and we are using to implement that words in our speaking when we are speaking with others in that area. And slowly we will learn, and after some time, without any problem, we can able to fluently speak in that language. At that time also, we won't learn any grammar. Like that in English also, to communicate with others, no need to learn the grammar. Just we have to learn some rules or some meanings. Why? Because first we should know what is the meaning of that word or what is the meaning of that sentence when we are speaking with others. Otherwise, we may be in a soup. So, first, I will tell one Telugu word. Nenu. School ki velutunnanu. Nenu school ki velutunnanu. School ki velutunnanu. If I want to tell this in English, first nenu, I, school. Velutunnanu, the action is going on, not completed, he not reached school. So the action is going on or it is in continuous manner. So V1 plus ING, velutunnanu, what is velutunnanu? Go plus ING, going. I school going. If I will speak like this, everybody will laugh. So we have to know the structure of the sentence. In sentence we are having two parts. One is subject and second one is predicate. Subject is the person or thing for which we are speaking in the sentence. and the predicate is the information which we are giving about that particular subject. Here I, then we have to write the verb. This is right, going to school. This is right?
No.
To connect this and make this in effective manner, we have to take the help of be form verb. Then this sentence will complete manner and it will in a correct manner. I am going to school. For example, I am speaking about, this is the first person singular, so I am using I am going to school. When the subject is I, we have to use am only as be form verb and going to school. If we are speaking about third person, then we have to write third person singular. He is going to school. Third person singular when we are using, is will come in the place of am. He is going to school. She is going to school. Like that, it will come. And when the plural forms will come, in the first person, we are in the subject, then we are going to school. And third person plural is, they are going to school. But for the second person, you is the only word for second person for singular and plural. So we have to use you are going to school for plural and for singular also. You are going to school. Like that, we have to use am, is, and are in our pronunciation or in our speaking. When we are speaking with others, we have to use am, is, are. When the subject is I, we have to use am. And when the subject is third person, he, she, it, then we have to use the is as helping verb, and you is the single word which is used to for second person singular and second person plural. So we have to use are. You are going to school. These are all in present tense, present continuous. If this will be, this was happened yesterday, something happened yesterday, then with I you have to use was, not am. If I was late, if yesterday I was late to school, I was late. For every thought singular, in past tense we have to use was only, except second person. For the third person and for the third person and the first person singular, we have to use was as the be form verb. He was late, she was late, I was late. But when we are coming to the plural and singular of the second person, in the place of are, we have to use verb. You were late, they were late, we were late. Like this, we have to use. Okay? And in our communication, when we are communicating, where the has or have will go. If the subject is singular pronouns like he, she, and nouns, singular nouns, Ram, Sita, like the singular nouns, are pronouns of singular, he, she are there,
then we have to use has. For example, he has to do this work. He has to do this work. If she comes, also she has to do this work. If Ram is subject, Ram has to do this work. If the subject is singular pronouns like he, she or it, and the subjects are singular nouns like Ram, Sita, then we have to use has with the subject. He has to do this work. It has to do this work. She has to do this work. Ram has to do this work. Sita has to do this work. Like this, we have to use in sentences. And the next one, have. Where the have will come? If the subject is I and we and they and plurals, we have to use have. I have to do this work. I have to do this work. They have to do this work. These are also plurals, in singular plural and third person plural. And you pronoun I is the subject, we have to use have to do this work. If we is the subject, we have to do this subject work. If they is the subject, they have to do this work. And if you is the subject, you have to do this work. Plurals, I. The boys have to do this work. The boys have to do this work. Boys is the plural. If we are having two singular nouns and making it as a plural, Ram and Sita, Ram and Sita have to, Ram and Sita have to do this work. Ram and Sita. Actually, Ram is singular and Sita is singular. But when we are using in a single sentence, we are two persons are in our sentence. So this is the plural. So we have to use have. Ram and Sita have to do this work. Like this, many rules are there. We have to learn some rules. When we learn the rules, easily we can able to communicate effectively without any hesitate, and nobody will laugh on our communication, or nobody will point out our communication is wrong or any mistakes are there. And the next we will learn the remaining parts, what are the rules are there in communication. Thank you.